North Shore churches are stepping up tonight to help people on the Gulf Coast whose livelihoods have been affected by the oil spill.
Call it food for the body and food for the soul. WDSU North Shore reporter Heath Allen shows us how far a bucket of hope can go.
It was tragedy that it happened, and it affects a lot of our kids.
From the moment people realized an entire way of life was in jeopardy on the Gulf Coast, folks have wanted to help. And that desire to reach out to those in need gave birth to Buckets of Hope for Louisiana.
We'll get some coffee and we'll get some Tony Sacheries and we'll put some Tabasco and rice and flour and oil.
Congregation members at Southern Baptist churches across the North Shore filling up those big orange buckets from the Home Depot. Each family, each bucket, a way to reach out and help someone struggling on the Gulf Coast.
You just wonder, okay, how are they going to get their next meal? How are they going to pay for their you know, the school supplies and stuff like that, or the meal on the tables?
The idea originally sparked in the wake of the earthquake in Haiti. Tens of thousands of buckets went to that devastated nation. Here at home, the whole thing seemed to make perfect sense in the wake of the spill in the Gulf. Churches will spend this weekend assembling the buckets. They'll be loaded onto trucks, headed for other Baptist churches dotted along the Gulf. And from there, they'll be distributed to those in need. Everything will be put to good use, especially the bucket.
So hopefully they can use this for something else, even if it's just to sit on and take a break and just wonder when all of this will end.
We are resilient. We definitely are, considering all the big ones that we've gone through.
And with that attitude, there's always hope. A bucket of it. On your side on the North Shore, Heath Allen, WDSU News.
Very nice. And the first truck loads of buckets will be shipped to the Venice and Grand Isle areas early next week.